and adopted the program forward. Thank you very much.
Morning.
Morning.
Are you good?
Yes.
I'm also good. My name is Khawela. I am from the NSTF. We are based in Pretoria at the CSIR campus. Have you ever heard about the NSTF before? NSTF is the National Science and Technology Forum. So what we do at the NSTF is we promote science. So we have about more than 100 organizations that are members of the NSTF. Those organizations, some are doing engineering work, innovation, math, actually the SET community. When we say the SET community, we mean science, engineering, and technology. So wherever you see the word SET, just know that it's science, engineering, technology. Of course, now they have included innovation as well. So that is what the NSTF is doing. We are promoting science. How do we promote this science? Through doing discussion forums, whereby we have the SET community again, gathering together, discussing issues that are involved in South Africa, like the climate change, everything that we'll be facing at that particular time, we gather people around, they should talk about those issues. And we also close to the government. So after those discussion forums, we can easily talk to the government to say, you know what, this is what the people are saying at the moment. Can you please do something about it? You get my point. Okay, and then how are we again promoting this site? Like now, we are here. Why are we here? We want to motivate you. We want to share the knowledge that we have. I've brought a speaker with me who's more knowledge than I am, than you are. So we are here to give you the knowledge, to share with you whatever that we know, whatever that we have experience in this field of science, and to dare you to go and share that knowledge that you would have got here with your fellow learners. You get my point? So that is what basically the share and dare is about, and NSTF is doing. So share and dare is more like a project that NSTF is having. You get my point? The other thing that we do at NSTF for youth, because we have a youth outreach extra actually, what we do is it's called a brilliance program. The brilliance program is what we do, we take two learners from each province, a girl and a boy. Those learners would have got the highest mark in mathematics and science in grade 12 in the whole province. So for instance, if it's Cape Town, we will take two learners, a girl and a boy, who got the highest marks in math and science. You get my point? And then you go to another province, we do the same. So at the end of the day, we'll be having 18 learners because we have 9 provinces. And then sometimes you find that in each province, there's 2 girls who got the same marks in math, same marks in physics. What do we do? So of course, we'll have to take both of them. So sometimes it's not 18, it's 20, but that's what the brilliance is all about. And then, because, okay, NSTF also do awards, science awards. They call them the science Oscars. So we award our researchers, our communication specialists for the work that they do. And after that, those awards, we take them to talk to people like you, to encourage you that one day you'll be a researcher, one day you'll win an award for science. It's not only the musicians and the actors that get the awards. You can still get an award as a scientist. So after those awards, that's when we take our award winners to go and talk to learners to show them that there's good things in science. We can still enjoy science. It's not like when you're doing science, you're doing a boring subject, so you cannot enjoy anything in that field. Get my point? So you can still enjoy science. You can still win awards in science. You can still slay in science. You get my point? Yes, and then because after we know that, okay, there's a process for the awards. Mind you, they have to fill in the application forms and whatever
then after, when we know that, okay, we have our finalists, and then we have to award our winners. We have a gala dinner, and a week before that gala dinner, we take the brilliant students to a talk. We do that in collaboration with the SKA. They take them to very interesting places, I should tell you. I always wish I could go with them, but because of all the work in the office, I can't. So I have a video here with me that I would just like to show you what a brilliant go to, what do they do? Because I think I might have few, if not all of you, but it can't be all of you because we only meet two from here. So I might have two who will be going to the brilliant store with me. So let me just show you a bit what all those students gave. That's just a part of what they get. They get more, they get bursaries, they get a lot. So please just study, make sure that you get the highest marks in math and science, and then you'll be on that top. So while they're busy doing that video for us, I just want to introduce our speaker for today. Our speaker is an NSTF award winner. Like I told you, we take our award winner to come and talk to you. So she's an award winner for Research Communication Award towards achieving sustainable water management knowledge generation and solution with demonstrated leadership and impact. She leads the Environmental and Nanoscience Research Group at the University of Western Cape, which is known for research of water chemistry and effluent remediation. This includes treating and removing organics and inorganics from industrial brine, acid mine drainage, and textile wastewater. Another outstanding contribution that she does is the development of process for industrial waste reuse. She was the recipient of the 2017-2018 NSTF Awards, like I told you. The award category was the Research Commission Award for her work towards achieving sustainable water management, knowledge generation and solutions. She has contributed significantly in skill development and innovation in the field of environmental remediation, water treatment and water waste reuse in South Africa. And our speaker is Professor Leslie Petrik. Yeah. All right, so we can just welcome our speaker for now.